that's revenue.
4 days will quickly seep into night. 4 nights will quickly dream away the time. And then the moon, like to a silver bow new bent in heaven, shall behold the night of our solemnity.
Hippolyta, I woo thee with my sword, and want thy love doing thee injuries. But I will wed thee in another key, with pomp, with triumph, and with reveling.
Happy be Theseus, our renowned duke.
Thanks, Cadigius. What's the news with thee?
Full of vexation, I come with complaints against my child. My daughter Hermia, stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander, and my gracious duke. This man has bewitched the bosom of my child, and with cunning haste filched my daughter's heart, and turned her obedience, which is due to me, to stubborn harshness. And my gracious duke, be it such, he will not hear before your grace. Consent to marry Demetrius. I beg the ancient laws of Athens. As she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall either be to this gentleman, or to her death, according to our law, immediately provided in that case.
What say you, Hermia? Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander.
In himself he is, but in this kind, wanting your father's voice, the other must be held a worthier.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me. I know not by what power I am emboldened, but I beseech your grace that I may know the worst that may befall me in this case, if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Die the death, and to abjure forever the society of men.
Relent, sweet Hermia, and Lysander. Yield thy title craze to my certain right. You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. Do you marry him?
Scornful Lysander! True, he hath my love, and what is mine, my love shall render him. And she is mine, and all my right of her I do estate unto Demetrius.
I am, my lord, as well derived as he. As well possessed, my love is more than his. As well more than all these both can be. I am beloved of beauteous Hermia. Demetrius, I'll avouch it to his head. Made love to Nidar's daughter, Helena.
I must confess that I have heard so much, and with Demetrius thought him spoke thereof. But being over full of self-affairs, my mind did lose it.
But come, Aegeus, and come, Demetrius. I have some private schooling for you both. And you, fair Hermia, look you arm yourself to fit the fancies of your father's will, or the law of Athens yields you up to die or to vow single life.
With duty and desire we follow.
Oh my God.
How down, my love? How chance the roses there do fade so fast?
Be like for want of rain which I could blow, but teen them from the tenderness of my eyes.
I mean, the course of true love never did run smooth. Therefore, hear me, Hermia. I have a widow aunt, a doe-wether, of great revenue, and she hath no child. From Athens is her house remote 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. There, gentle Hermia, may I marry thee? And to that place the sharp Athenian law cannot pursue us. If thou lovest me then, seal forth thy father's house tomorrow night. And tomorrow, in the league of the town, there will I meet with thee.
My good Lysander, I swear to thee, by Cupid's strongest bow, tomorrow truly will I meet with thee.
He promised love.
Demetrius!
Look, here comes Helena.
Godspeed, fair Helena, whither away?
Point me fair, that fair again unsafe. Demetrius loves your fair, oh happy fair. Your eyes load stars and your tongue sweet air. Oh teach me with what art you sway the motion of Demetrius' heart.
I frown upon him, yet he loves me still.
And then your frowns with such affection move.
I give him curses, yet he gives me love.
And then my prayers with such affection move.
The more I hate, the more he follows me.
The more I love, the more he hateth me.
Comfort, he no more shall see my face, for Lysander and myself shall fly this place, and in the woods, where often you and I, upon patron rosebuds, were wont to lie, there my Lysander and myself shall meet, and thence from Athens turn away our eyes to seek new friends and stranger companies. Farewell, sweet playfellow, pray thou for us, and good luck grant thee thy Demetrius. Keep word, Lysander, we must starve our sight to love her sweet tomorrow in the night.
I will, my Hermia. Helena, adieu. As you and him demote, Demetrius, dote on you.
How happy some or other some can be. Through Athens, I am thought as fair as she. But what of that? Demetrius thinks not so. He will not know what all but he do know, and as he is, doting on Hermia's eyes, so I, admiring of his qualities, think his base and vile, folding no quantity. Love contends first to form and dignities. Love looks not with the eyes, but in the mind, and therefore, as when Cupid painted blind, thou hadst love of any judgment taste, wings, and no eyes, figure, and heedy haste. And therefore is love said to be a child, because in choice he's so oft beguiled. as raggish boys and games themselves forswear, so the boy love is perjured everywhere. For ere Demetrius looked on Hermia's eye, he hailed out oaths that he was only mine. And this hailsome heat from Hermia felt, so he dissolved and showered to oaths that melt. I will go tell him of fair Hermia's flight. Then to the wood will he tomorrow night pursue her. And for this intelligence, if I have faith, it is a dear expense. But you and me now turn rich my pay to have a sight thither and back again.
Is all our company here?
You are best to call them general, man by man, according to the script.
Here is the scroll of every man's name, which thought fit to roll out to play in our interlude for the Duke and the Duchess on his wedding day at night.
First, good Peter Quince.
Say what the play treats on.
Then read the names of the actors.
And so, grow to a point.
Mary, our play is the most lamentable comedy, the most cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
Ooh. A merry play, and a welcome. Now,
Peter Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll.
Masters, spread yourselves.
Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the weaver.
Ready. Name what part I am for and proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, are sent down for Pyramus.
What is Pyramus? A lover or a tyrant?
A lover that kills himself most gallant for love.
That will ask some tears in the true performing of it. If I do it,
let the audience look to their eyes.
I will move storms. I will condole in some measure.
The raging locks and shivering shocks shall break the locks of prison gates.
Now, name the rest of the players.
Francis Foote, the bellows manager.
Here, Peter Quince.
Foote, you must take Thisbe on you.
And what is Thisbe? A wandering knight?
It is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Make me not play woman. I have a beard tummy.
That is all one. We shall play to the mat, and you may speak as small as you will.
And I may hide my face. Let me play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice.
Thisbe! Thisbe!
Ah, Pyramus dear, thy lady dear, and lover dear.
Well, proceed.
Robin Starveling, the tailor?
Here, Peter Quince.
Robin Starveling, you are set down for Thisbe's mother. Tom Snout, the tinker?
Here, Peter Quince.
You, Pyramus' father? Myself, Thisbe's father? Snug, the joiner? You, the lion's part? And I hope here is a play fitted.
Have you the lion's part written? Pray you, if it be, give it me, for I am slow of study.
You may do it extempore, for it is nothing but roaring.
I may roar. Let me be the lion, too. I will roar, that it will do any man's heart good to hear me. I will roar, that I will make the Duke say, let him roar again. Let him roar again. Roar!
You should do it too terribly. You would fright the Duchess and the ladies, that they would shriek, and that were enough to hang us all.
That would hang us, every mother's son.
You can play no part but Pyramus, for Pyramus is a sweet-faced man. A lovely man, as one should see in a summer's day. The most lovely gentleman-like man. Therefore, you must needs play Pyramus.
Wow. I will undertake it.
Masters, here are your parts. I am to entreat you, request you, and desire you to con them by tomorrow night and meet me at the palace wood, a mile from the town, by moonlight. There will be rehearsed. I pray you fail me not.
Aye, we will meet. Most, and there we may rehearse. Most obscenely and courageously.
Take care. Be perfect.
Adieu.
Acorn cups and hide in there.
Either I'm mistaken, Shake, or making point.
Or you're the shrewd and neighbor sprite.
Help, Robin, good fella!
Thou speakest right. I am the merry wonder of night. But root fairies, here comes Oberon!
And here, my mistress!
Would the heavy be gone?
You'll met by moonlight, Ratatania?
What? Jealous Oberon? Fairies, he has. I have forsworn his bed in company.
How can Sir Terry rationalize him when I am not thy lord?
Then I must see thy lady. Why art thou here, come from the finest deep of India? But that, forsooth, the bouncing Amazon, the buskin mistress, and your warrior love, to Theseus must be wedded, and you come to give him that joy and prosperity.
How canst thou thus for shame, Titania, glance at my pretty with Hippolyta, knowing I know thy love to Theseus?
These are the forgeries of jealousy. And never, since the middle summer spring, met me on hill, in dale, forest or mead, by paved mountain or by rushy brook, or in the beached margin of the sea, to dance our ringlets to the whistling wind, but with thy brawls thou hast disturbed our sport. The human mortals want their winter here. No night is now with pain or carol blessed. Therefore the moon, the governess of floods, pale in her anchor, washes all the air that rheumatic diseases do abound, and thorough this distemperature we see the seasons alter. Hoary-headed frosts, far in the fresh lap of the crimson rose, and at all times thin and icy crown, an odorous chaplet of sweet summer buds is as in mockery set. The spring, the summer, the childing autumn, angry winter change their wonted liveries, and the mazed world by their increase no doubt which is which. And the same progeny of evils come to my debate, from our dissension. We are their parents and original.
You amend it then? It lies in you. Why should Titania cross her Oberon? I do but beg a little changeling child to be my henchman.
Set your heart at rest. The fairy land buys not the child of me. His mother was a vultress in my order, and in the spiced Indian air by night, full often has she gone to by my side, and sat with me on Neptune yellow sands, marking the embarked traders in the flood, when we have laughed to see the sails conceive, and rope and bellied with the wanton wind, which she, with pretty and with swimming gait following, her room then rich with my young squire would imitate, and sail upon the land to fetch me trifles, she being mortal and this boy did die, and for her sake do I merit the boy, and for her sake I will not part with him.
How long have been this wood intend you say?
Perchance till after Theseus' wedding day. Fairies away, we shall charm thy right if I longer stay.
Well, go thy way! Thou shalt not from this grove till I torment thee for this injury. I just have come hither.
Thou remember since once I sat upon a promontory and saw a mermaid riding on a dolphin's back, uttering such dulcet and harmonious breath that the rude sea grew civil at her song, and stars shot madly from their spheres to hear the sea maid's music?
I remember.
There I saw, but thou couldst not, flying between the cold moon and the earth. Cupid all armed, a certain aim he took, and a fair vessel thrown by the west. He loosed his love shaft smartly from his bow, and it fell upon a little western flower. Once milk white, now purple with love's wound. The maidens called it love and idleness. Fetch me that flower, dear, I showed thee once. If the juice of it on sleeping eyelids lay will make man or woman madly dote upon the next live creature it sees.
You can put a girdle round about thee within 40 minutes.
Meow! Having once this juice, I'll wash it tiny while she is asleep. I'll lay the liquor of it in her eyes, and the next thing she then waking looks upon, be it on lion or bear or wolf or bull, on meddling monkey or on busy ape, I'll make her, she'll pursue it with the soul of love. And ere I take this charm from off her sight, as I can take it with another charm, I'll make her render up her page to me.
I love thee not, never pursue me not.
But who comes here? I'm invisible when we're over here at the conference.
Where is Lysander and Fera Hermia? Hath you gone and follow me no more?
You draw me, you hard-hearted advent!
Do I not speak fair to not entice you, when rather in the plainest like truth, do I say I can or cannot love you?
And even for that, do I love you the more? Hi, Miss Spaniel! And Demetrius, the more you beat me, I will fawn on you, spurn me, strike me, neglect me, lose me. Only give me leave, and worthy as I am to follow you.
Tell me not too much, for I'm sick when I do look upon you.
I'm sick, but I will not on you!
Let go of me, and do not believe I shall do thee mischief in the wood.
Aye, in the temple, in the town, in the field, you do me mischief. I will follow thee, and make a heaven of hell. Die upon the hand I love so well.
Fare thee well, then. Thou shalt fly, and he shall seek thy love.
Yeah.
Aye, there it is.
Take thou some of it and seek through this grove. A sweet Athenian lady is in love with a disdainful youth. Anoint his eyes, but do, and the next thing he espies may be the lady. Affect it with some care that he may prove more fond on her than she upon her love, and me be ere the first cock crow.
Fear not, my lord, your servant shall do so.
Fair love, you faked your blood in the wood.
And to speak truth, I have forgot our way. Oh, restless Hermia, if you think it new. I tarried for the comfort of the day.
Beat Zola Sander, find you a bed, for I'm on this bank. Shut up my head.
One turf shall serve as a pillow for us both. One bed, one heart, two bosoms, and one truth.
Nay, good Lysander, for my sake, my dear, lie further up yet. Do not lie so near. Such separation, as may well be said, becomes a virtuous bachelor and a maid. So far be distance. And good night, sweet friend, thy love ne'er alter, though thy sweet life end.
Here is my bed. Sleep give thee all his rest.
Through this forest I've gone, but Athenians I've found none, whose eyes I might approve with this flower's force and stirring love. Night and silence, who is here?
Weeds of Athens he doth wear.
This is he, my master said, despise the Athenian maid. And here's a maiden sleeping sound on the dank and dirty ground.
When thou awakest, let love forbid, sleep his seat on thy eyelids. Now awakes when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon.
Turkey head, do not haunt me thus.
Oh, thou dost not leave me!
Stay on that
peril. Do not so!
Stay on that peril, I will go alone.
That vile word, to perish on my sword.
Oh, do not say so, Sandus, say not so. But thou we love you, Hermia. Oh, Lord, but thou, Hermia still loves you. Then be content.
Content with Hermia? Ugh, no, I do repent. The tedious minutes I've spent with her. Not Hermia, but Helena do I love. Who will not change a raven for a dove?
Wherefore was I to this king mockery born? I knew your hand, and I deserve this scorn. I thought you lord of all true gentleness. Oh, that a lady of one man have refused, should of another therefore be abused.
She sees not Hermia. Hermia, sleep thou there. Never mayest come Lysander near.
Helena!
Help me, Lysander, help me do thy best to pluck this crawling serpent from my breast. Lysander, look how I do quake with fear. Lysander! What removed, Lysander, Lord, what out of hearing? Gone. No sound? No word?
Ooh!
Well, then I perceive you are not nigh.
Ooh!
Either death or you will find immediately.
Seems safe. We will do no harm with our swords.
Roar! Roar! Roar!
Will not the ladies be afraid of the lion?
I fear it. I promise you. Therefore,
for another prologue must be written saying that he is not a lion.
Nay. He must speak, and half his face must be seen through the lion's net. And he indeed must speak, and say thus, or to the same effect. Ladies, or fair ladies, I would entreat you, or I would wish you, or I would request you, not to fear, not to tremble. My life for yours. If you think I come hither as a liar, to have pity on my life, no, I am no such thing. I am a man, as other men are. And then indeed, let him name his name, and tell them plainly, he is...
Snell,
the joiner.
Well, it shall be so. There's two hard things, that is, to bring the moonlight into the chambers. For you will know, by moonshine, did Pyrrhus and Thisbe meet by moonlight?
Doth the moon shine the night we flare away?
A calendar! Look in the almanac! Find out moonshine! Find out moonshine!
What's an almanac?
Yes, it doth shine that night!
Why? Then you may leave a casement of the great chamber window where we play, open, and the moon may shine in at the casement.
Or else, one must come in with a bush of thorn and a lantern and say he comes to disfigure or to present a person of moonshine.
Fera, seriously?
Then there is another thing. Meet a wall in the great chamber. For Pyrrhus and Thisbe, says the story, did talk through the chink of a wall.
You can never bring the wall. What say you, madam?
Some man or other must present wall. And let him have some rough cast or low without him. And let him hold his fingers thus. And through that hole shall Pyramus and Thisbe whisper.
If that may be, then all is well. Come sit down, every mother's son, and rehearse your parts. Pyramus, you begin. When you have spoken to speak, enter into that parade. So everyone according to his feet. Speak, dear miss.
Thisbe, stand forth.
Thisbe, thy flowers of odious savor sweet.
Odors,
savor sweet. So hath thy breath, my lovely Thisbe deep. But hark, a voice. Stay here. But you are one, and by and by, I will to thee appear.
Must I speak now?
Aye, Mary, must you?
Oh, Pyramus!
I will walk up and down, and I shall sing,
that they shall know I am not afraid. The oosel cock so black of hue, with orange tawny bill, the throstle with his note so true, the wren with little quill.
What angel wakes me from my flowery bed? Oh, I pray thee, gentle mortal, sing again. Mine ear is much enamored of thy note, so is mine eye enthralled by thy shape, that thy fair virtue's force perforce doth move me upon the first view to say, to swear, I love thee.
Methinks, mistress, you should have little reason for that. And yet, to say the truth, love and reason hold little company nowadays.
Thou art wise as thou art beautiful.
Not so neither. But if I had wit enough to get out of this wood, I had enough to serve mine own turn.
Out of this wood do not desire to go. Thou shalt remain here, whether thou wilt or no. I'll give thee fairies to attend on thee, and they shall fetch thee jewels from the deep, and sing while thou in crescent flowers dost sleep. And I will purge thy mortal grossness so that thou shalt like an airy spirit go. Peas blossom, cobweb, moth, and musket seed.
Lady!
And I!
Where shall we go?
Be kind and courteous to this gentleman. Hop in his walks and gamble in his eyes. Nod to mouths and do courtesies.
Hail, mortal.
Hail.
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 I cry your worship's mercy. Heartily. Your name, honest gentleman?
Peace, Blossom!
Good peas, Blossom. I commend you. Hail! Your mother, Mistress Squash! And I must meet your father, Master Peace God! And good peas, Blossom. I pray you. I must come to know you more as well.
Come, wait upon him. Lead him to my bower. Hide my love's tongue. Bring him silently.
I wonder if the time of you awake. Then what was the next human arrival that she must dote on in extremity?
Meow,
here comes
meow,
my messenger.
Meow, meow.
How now, mad spirit?
My mistress with the monster is in love, near to her close and consecrated brow, in her dull and sleeping hours. A group of patches, rude mechanicals, that work for bread upon the Athenian stall, were met together to rehearse and play, intended for the great Theseus's nuptial, the shallowest, thick-skinned of barren sort. And Pyramus was there, presented in their sport. Forsook his scene and entered a break, and on his thin speed must be answered.
And forth my mimic, coming out of sight, his fellows did fly. And in that moment it came to pass, the town he awaked, and straightaway loved, in it.
Dead, for I can tell.
I pray thee, tell me then that he's well.
If I should, what should I get there for?
A privilege, never see me more. What are you doing? Oh.
There is no point following her in this fierce vein. Here for a while I will remain.
What hast thou done? Thou art mistaken quite, and laid the love juice on some true love's sight. About the wood look thou find, and Helena of Athens. Helena, tall, blonde, accent, Helena of Athens, look thou fine. By some illusion, drink her here. I'll charm his eyes again, she do appear.
I go. Look how I go. Swifter than an arrow from Tartar's bow. Meow!
Flower of this purple dye, hit with Cupid's archery. Sink in apple of his eye, till his lovey doth espy. Make her shine as gloriously as the Venus of the sky. When you wake, if she be by, beg for her remedy.
Captain of our fairy band, Helena is here at hand, and the youth is still for me, pleading for Lord's sake.
Shall we perform pageantry, Lord? What fools these mortals be!
Stand aside, the noises they make will cause Demetrius to awake.
Why should you think that I am doing sore?
His vows are Hermia's. Will you give her all?
I had no judgment to her, I swore.
Then in my mind, now you give her all.
Demetrius loves her, and he loves not you.
Oh, Helena, goddess, nymph, perfect divine, to what my love shall compare to thine eye, crystals, my
right. Those tempting cherries kissing me. I see all for your manliness. Few a civil and new courtesy, you not do me thus injury. Few a manners, men you are, and show. Do not do a gentle lady so, to vow and swear, and super praise my parts, when I'm sure you hate me with all your heart. You were both rivals to love Hermia, and now both rivals to mock Helena.
You're unkind, Demetrius, be not so. For you love Hermia, this you know, I know.
Lysander, keep thy Hermia. Look, where love comes, yonder is thy dear.
Thou art my not mine high Lysander crowned. My dear, I thank you, it brought me to thyself, but why unkindly didst thou leave me so?
Why should he say, who long doth press to go?
Well, love confess Lysander from my side.
Lysander's love than love left in mine. For Helena, who more in goods than night, than all you Phareos and eyes of light.
You speak not as you think. It cannot be.
Lo! She is one of this confederacy. Now I perceive they have conjoined all three to fashion this false sport in spite of me.
Injurious Hermia, most ungrateful maid! Have you conspired, have you at least contrived to bait me in this foul division?
Is all the counsel that we two have shared, the sisters' vows, the hours that we have spent, when we have chid the hasty for the time of parting us? Oh, is it all forgot? It's not friendly, just not maidenly, of sex as well as I may chide you for, though I alone do feel the injury.
I scorn you not. It seems that you scorn me.
Have you not set Lysander as a scorn to follow me and praise my eyes and face? And such your other love, Demetrius, who even now has spurned me with his foot, call me goddess, divine and rare, precious and celestial?
I understand not what you mean by this.
Stay, gentle heart. Hear my excuse.
And I can't compel.
Thou canst compel no more than she entreats. Helen, I love thee. By my life, I do.
I say, I love thee more than he can do.
Why are you grown so rude? What change is this? Am I not Hermia? Are you not Lysander? Since night you love me, and since night you left me.
I, by my life, and never did desire to see thee more. Therefore, bid of hope, of question, of doubt. Be not injured, 'tis no jest, that I do hate thee. Love Helena.
Oh, me, you juggler, you changer, most of you thief of love, have you come by and stolen my love's heart from him?
Fine, I pray. Have you no modesty, no maiden shame, no touch of bashfulness? Fly by you, you counterfeit, you puppet, you!
Puppet? Why so? Aye, that way goes the aim. No, I perceive she had made compare between our statures, she had urged her height, and now you've grown so high in this esteem because I'm so dwarfish and yet so low. How low am I, thou painted maid? Well, speak, how low am I? I am not yet so low, but that my nails can be shook to the
Gentlemen,
love
and not hear me! You may think me yes, she's something low with that one!
Now fall if thou darest to try who's right. Of thine and mine
is most in Helena. I won't go with deep cheek myself.
You mistress, all this coil of song of you. Nay, go not back.
I no longer trust you. I no longer say in your cursed company. Your hands and mine are quicker for a fight. My legs are longer, to run away!
I am amazed and know not what to say.
This is thy negligence! Still I was making quite a row, or else against thy neighbors willfully! Oh, sorry!
Believe me, King of Shadows, I mistook, but did you not say I should know the man by the Athenian garments he had on?
Thou cease these lovers seeking place to fight. I, therefore, Robin, overcast the night and leave these testy rivals so astray. All one, come not within another's way. Then crush this herb into Lysander's eye.
No, to me.
Lysander.
To me.
Lysander.
To me.
There's only one Lysander.
Which is it?
Lysander!
Lysander.
Sander.
Lysander.
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 Okay. When he awake, all this aversion shall seem a dream and fruitless vision. Well, are I back to Athens shall these lovers wed, which lead whose date till death shall never end. Whilst I in this affair do thee employ, I'll to my queen and beg her Indian boy. And then I will her charmed eye release from monster's view, and all things shall be peace.
up and down, I lead them up and down. I am feared in field and town, goblin lead them up and down.
Words of proud Demetrius. Like that, speak again.
Speak thou now.
Ah! A weary night, a long and tedious night. Abate that hour, shine comforts from the east. If I make back to Athens by daylight, not this my poor company detests. And sleep that sometimes shuts up soul's eye. Steal me a while to find no company.
Yep, three come one more, two of a kind will make him four. Here she comes, crust and sad. Cupid is an Avis lad, that to make poor females mad.
Never so weary, never so in love. He dallied with dew and torn briars. I can no further crawl, no further go. My legs can keep no pace with my desires. Here, I rest me till the break of day. Heaven, to Lysander, then you pray.
On the ground, sleeping sound, I apply to you?
Lysander!
Your eyes, gentle lover, remedy. Good monsieur, get you your weapon in your hand and kill me a red crested bumblebee on top of a thistle. And good monsieur, fetch me the honey pot.
Wilt thou hear some music, my sweet love? Or say, sweet love, what thou desirest to eat?
Methinks I have a desire to abide hay. Good hay, sweet hay, hath no fellow.
I have a venturous fairy that shall seek the squirrel's hoard and fetch thee new nuts.
But I pray you, let none of your people wake me, for I have an exposition of sleep come upon me.
Sleep thou, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies, be gone, and be always away. Oh, how I love thee, how I dote on thee.
Her dotage I do now begin to pity, for meeting her of late behind the wood, seeking sweet favors from this hateful fool, I did upbraid her and fell out with her. I then did ask of her changeling child which strength she gave me, and her fairy sent him to bear my bower in fairy land. And now that I have the boy, I'll release this hateful imperfection of her eyes. And, gentle talk.
But you said I was done.
Take the scalp from off the head of this Athenian swain. That one. When he awaking, when the other do, make them think of this night and no more of the fierce vexation of a dream. But first, I release my fairy queen. See, be as thou wert wont to be, seest thou wast wont to see. Dying bud or cupid's flower hath such face and blessed power. Now, my Titania, wake you, my sweet queen.
My Oberon, what visions have I seen? I thought I was enamored of an axe.
There lies your love.
Ta-da!
How came these things to pass? Oh, how mine eyes do loathe his visage now.
Silence a while. Robin, take off his head.
Thou wakest of thine own fool's eyes. Hee-haw, hee-haw. Excuse me, pardon, excuse me.
Sound music! Now, my Titania, take hands with me, and let us rock the ground on which these sleepers be.
Come, my lord, and in our flight, tell me how it came this night that I, sleeping here, was found with these mortals on the ground.
Come, and I will answer. My next is, most fair Pyramid. Peter Quince. Flip, the bellows mender. Snog, the joiner. Stubbling. God's my life. Stolen hence left me asleep. I have had a most rare vision. I have had a dream. Past the wit of man to say what dream it was. Man is but an ass if he go about to expound my dream. Methought I was. There is no man that can say what. Methought I was. And methought I had, but man is a patched fool if you ask to say what methought I had. I will get Peter Quince to write a ballad of this dream. It shall be called Bottom's Dream, because it hath no bottom. And I shall sing it in the latter end of the play before the Duke. Peradventure, to make it the more gracious, I shall sing it at her death.
What nymphs are these?
My lord, this is my daughter Hermia, and this Lysander. and this Demetrius is, and this Helena, old Nidar's Helena. I wonder if they're being here together.
No doubt they rose up early to observe the rite of May, and in hearing our content, came in grace in our solemnity. But speak, Aegeus, is this not the day that Hermia gave the answer of her choice?
It is, my queen.
Good morrow, friends! St. Valentine is past! I pray you all, stand up. I know you two are rivals. How came this gentle concord in this world that hatred is so far from jealousy to sleep by hate and fear no enmity?
My lord, I shall reply amazingly. I came with Hermia, hither our intent was to be gone from Athens, where we might, without the peril of the Athenian.
Enough, law. Enough, my lord! You've heard enough! I beg the law, law upon his head!
My lord, fair Helen told me about their stealth in the wood, and in fancying I followed them. Helen, in fancying, followed me. But, my lord, my love for Hermia has melted in the snow, and the object of pleasure of thine eye is only Helena.
Fair lovers, you are fortunately met. Of this discourse we moral here anon.
But, my lord! Aegeus, I will overbear your will, for in the temple by and by with us these couples shall eternally be knit. And with the morning something new, our purpose hunting shall be set aside.
Away with us to Athens, three and three. We'll hold a feast in great solemnity.
Have you sent to Bottom's house? Is he come home yet?
He cannot be heard of. Out of doubt he is transported.
If he come not, leave the play as marred. It doth not go on, shall it?
Master, the Duke is coming through the temple, and there are two or three lords and ladies more merry. If our sport had gone forth, we had only made men.
But ask me not what. I am no true Athenian if I will tell you what happened. I will tell you each thing. Ready as it fell out.
Let us hear, sweet bottom.
Not a word of me. All I will say is that the Duke hath died. Get your apparel together. Good strings to your beards, new laces to your pelt. For the short and the long is our play is preferred. In any case, Let not he who plays the lion tear his nails, for they shall hang out as the lion's claws. And let him that plays this beat have clean linen. And, good masters, eat no garlic nor onions, for we are to utter sweet breath. And I do not doubt but to hear them sing. It is a sweet comedy. No more words. Away! Go away!
In their intent, extremely stretched and conned with cruel pain to do you service.
I will cure that play, for never anything can be amiss when simpleness and duty tender it.
Go, bring them in. And take your places, ladies.
Gentles, perchance you wonder at this show, but wonder on, till truth makes all things plain. This man is Pyramus. If you would know his beauty's lady, Thisbe is certain. This man, with lime and rough cap, doth present Wall, that vile wall which did these lovers suffer, and through Wall's chink, poor soul, they are content to whisper.
Whisper.
At the witch, let no man wonder. This man, with lanthorn, dog, and bush of thorn, presented moonshine.
Ta-da.
For you, if you will know, by moonshine did these lovers think no score to meet at night is tune, there to woo.
Aww.
This grisly beast with lion hide,
roar!
The trusty Thisbe coming first by night did scare away, or rather did affright. As she fled her mantle, she did fall, which lion vile with bloody mouth did stain. Anon comes Pyramus, sweet youth and tall, and finds his trusty Thisbe's mantle slain, whereat, with bloody, blameful blade, he bravely broached his boiling, bloody breast. And Thisbe, tarrying in mulberry shade, his dagger drew and died. For all the rest, like lion, moonshine, wall, and lovers twain, by large discourse, by here they do remain.
I wonder if the lion can speak.
No wonder, my lord. One lion may, many asses do.
In this same interlude, it doth befall the I one, Snout Lion.
Hello, my name is Snout. If you invest in me, I'll do business with you.
You know what? You get a business card, you get a business card, everyone gets a business card.
Oh. You seem like you want one slowly.
You're taking it.
Now!
Present a wall. And such a wall as I would have you think that had in it a cranny hole or chink. Through which the lovers, Pyramus and Thisbe, did often whisper very secretly, this loam, this rough cast, and this stone dust show, that I am that same wall, the truth is so. Through which the chink is right and sinister, through which the fearful lovers are to whisper.
Oh, night, the hue so black. Oh, night, which ever love when day is not. Oh, night, alack. I fear my Thisbe's promise is forgot. And thou, oh, sweet, lovely wall, that stands between her father's ground and mine. Oh, wall, oh, sweet, oh, lovely wall, show me thy cheek to blink through with mine eye. But what's he on? No Thisbe do I see. Oh, cursed wall, through whom I see no bliss. Cursed be thy stones,
for thus deceiving me.
Oh, well. How often hast thou heard my mom? These cherry lips have often kissed thy stones. Thy stones with hair and moss they thought to be.
I see a voice. Now will I to the cheek, the spot, and I can hear my Thisbe's face. Thisbe!
My love, thou art, my love.
Think what thou wilt. I am thy lover's grace. And like for mankind, am I trusty still.
And I like Helen, to the fate we kill.
Oh, kiss me through the hole of this vile heart.
I kiss the wall's hall, not your lips at all.
Wilt thou, at Ninis two,
Ninus two,
Ninus two, meet me straightway?
Thus have I, Wall, my part discharged itself. So thus shall I, Wall, away doth go.
This is the silliest stuff that I have ever heard.
You ladies, you whose gentle hearts did fear, the smallest monstrous mouth that creeps on floor, may now perchance both quake and tremble here. When lion roughs and wildest rage doth roar, then know that I, one, snug, the joiner, am a lion fell nor less no lion's den. For if I should, as lions come in strength, enter this place, 'twere pity on my life.
Ta-da. This lanthorn doth the horn man present.
She should have won the horn that his head.
This lanthorn doth the horn man present. Myself, the man, I the moon, do seem to be.
I'm aweary of his whom, when he would change.
All that I have to say is that the lantern is the moon. Myself, the man in the moon. This dormish, my dormish. And this dog, my dog.
So bright, for by your gracious gold glittering light, I trust the tint of truest Thisbe's sight. But stay, O spite, but mark, poor knight, what dreadful dole is this? I, do you see? How can it be? O dainty duck, O dear, thy mantle good? What, stained with blood? Oh, wherefore, nature, didst thou lion's flay? Since lion vile hath here deflowered my deal, which is, no, which was the fairest dame that lived, that loved, that liked, that looked with cheer. Oh, Thisbe, oh, Thisbe, oh, Thisbe, you are dead, slain by the lion. Thisbe is no more. I loved her so. She was slain, and now she's dead. And now you watch, and she is dead, and you do not even cry. But she's dead, and I loved her. Dead, 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 dead. I loved her, and she's dead. Dead as Thisbe. Dead, dead, dead.
Oh! Come, Tam, it's kind of found.
Outsword and wound. That pack of cannabis. Aye, that left pack. Well, how the fuck?
Thus die. Thus.
Now, am I dead? No. Am I fled? My soul is in the sky.
Moon, take that flight.
Tongue,
lose thy light.
Now, die. Die!
Skin yourself!
Die!
Fur!
Thank you.
hearts have offended, think but this and all is mended. While you but sleeping here, while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme, no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend, if you pardon, we will mend, as I am an honest pup, if we have an unearned love. Not to scape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends or long. Else the pup a liar calls, so good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore. Amen.